almost everything that we've built can be affected. Everything that we rely on, water, infrastructure, the roads, highways, railroad. So when there is a major natural disaster, such as an earthquake, a flood, a hurricane, tornado, there is an area that's impacted. And many times what we do as researchers is we go to these areas to look, to understand what exactly happened and learn from that experience. Typically, that's a kind of a difficult process because you have always limited resources. We don't have a lot of good technical information about what happened, so that's why we're there. And so what we're exploring this project is the opportunity of using drones that can be sent from a launching point, collect data on what has happened, review that data, hopefully in an automatic way, and send people to the appropriate areas that now we know are of most scientific interest. We collect video or photos to create 3D models. This is what we're after, 3D models of whatever feature it is. By taking photos that have significant overlap with each other, you can actually start looking at all the sides and the entire 3D target. And so if you have overlapping photos, you can start recreating the 3D model and perform any type of measurement that we want in 3D space. The traditional way by which we're doing things will be for us to go on top of this feature, use a measuring tape or maybe a GPS, which can be dangerous, can be tremendously time-consuming, and can actually, at the end, cost a lot in terms of the amount of time and resource you need to allocate. The drones can go there and could do the same much faster, with better resolution, with much more data than we would normally. By having good quality data of what happened in the field, we use that data to recalibrate our models, our design procedures, the way we handle stability issues, safety of structures, landslides, and revise these procedures so we can actually improve them in the future. I think there are tremendous opportunities. The drones could be sent there as the first agents to map these type of features. I've been to a number of reconnaissance following disasters in the past. You do your homework to the degree that you can from media, social media, and you land on the ground and you have to go to where you think, based on the information you have, is the most important sites. You could be wrong. It could take you days, because the roads are closed, the infrastructure is not there, there is no water, there could be a fire, there could be other disasters. You won't know until you get there. And so our vision is that in the future, in the near future, we'll be sending 10 drones or more in different directions, collect data, process that with automatic or semi-automatic routines, find the hotspots, and then send people in these hotspots to do the mapping that we're interested in. This technology, properly used, actually can help scientists like myself make leaps forward. But this is an evolving field, and I'm hoping that scientists can use this new technological tool for the public good.
So we're looking into understanding better vibrations that are induced during pile driving for deep foundations for bridges or structures. Most of the bridges in the state of Michigan are founded on shallow foundations, and these vibrations might...